Welcome to another full moon ritual. So the full moon is actually going to be officially full at 2:50 p.m. Eastern time in Libra or Libra, depending on how you say it, on March 28th. And this full moon is definitely a little bit of a gentle full moon. There's a lot of peaceful, harmonious energy around this full moon. And it's a good time in general just to feel like at peace and that harmony. And also, it's a really good time to focus on your relationships and to socialize. So just pay attention to how it is that you're feeling. If you want to socialize, go for it. If you, you know, just check in with yourself and your emotions. Another piece of this, of course, though, is that some of us might be feeling a little out of sorts or emotional right now. Tends to happen with the full moon, as it sometimes does heighten our emotions. And this full moon, it's closer to Earth than like the last full moon, but it's not so close that it's deemed like an official super moon. And a super moon is just a moon that's like really close to the Earth, basically. So emotions, they might be heightened. Know that that's the case. And just do your best to avoid conflict and legit, like, just relax when you can. You know, I feel like this weekend for me is going to be a weekend focusing on relaxing and, of course, probably a new project, but honor how you feel, basically. And just know that doing some type of physical activity right now may help clear your mind. So definitely some yoga, some Tai Chi, walking, anything physical will be really beneficial. And there's a lot of healing energy right now, a lot of healing. And of course, like with a full moon, this is our time to release. It is our time to give things over to the moon. So tonight we're going to really focus on surrendering and releasing and just letting it all go. And the other thing I will mention to you guys is we have entered into Aries season. So this is like the start of the astrological calendar. So just know, like, if you are feeling different energetically, that might be why. Like we're starting, we have the fire going on, fire season in a sense. So there are other things happening. You guys are welcome to look them up on YouTube, of course, but let's get started with tonight's ritual. So first we're going to clear our energy and I'm going to read you guys something while we do this. If you don't have Palo Santo or sage or spray or anything like that, you can just sit here and imagine like white light coming all over your body and surrounding you. So you can close your eyes if you want to do that. You can have them open as you imagine it, whichever you prefer. I'm going to grab some sage. And if you have sage or Palo Santo, definitely get the palms of your hands and the bottoms of your feet. And so I clear my energy of all that no longer serves me. I open my heart to receiving what is in my highest and greatest good. I allow myself to connect in deeply with my higher self and my own inner truth. I wash away all that is heavy and no longer serves me. I am now lighter. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Get that back. And then you guys can walk around your room or you can just imagine your room filling up with white light. I'm going to just continue sitting here so I can read this to you guys. But I cleanse the space of all negative vibes and of anything that is not in my highest and greatest good. I welcome in healing white light to fill this room plus all the other rooms in my home. This space is protected. This space is full of love. This space is safe. This space is healing. I ask any other loving guides to join in on my healing journey this evening. Thank you for the guidance and support. Thank you, thank you, thank you. And I'm gonna try to put this out because the smoke is thick. Calm it down. Okay, while I do this, you guys can grab a pen and paper, and we're gonna just hop into these questions. Okay, I think that's better. So I'm excited for these questions tonight. I think these will be some good ones. So our first question, and keep in mind, with Libra, Libra, however you pronounce it, we're talking about relationships. And you guys, some of you guys have heard me say this before, some of you have not. There's a way to heal relationships without having to talk to another person, okay? And so just keep that in mind tonight while we're going through these questions. So our first question is going to be, what relationships are my biggest concern right now? And what would help to transform them? So I'm going to put this in the chat, but I'll say it again. So what relationships are my biggest concern right now? What would help transform that relationship or them? Okay. So we'll take like at least, let's do some 7 minutes on this one. I'll check back in with you guys at 8:18. So I'm going to put on some music, put this in the chat, and let's focus on this question.
Thank you.
How are we doing with that question? Good. Good, good. Okay, cool. So for our next question, it's gonna be, what are you surrendering tonight? And this could be like outcomes that you've been holding on to, negative emotions that you might be clutching onto, just whatever it is that might be worrying you or preoccupying your mind. Like, it might not even be a negative, but what is it? What do you want to let go of and surrender tonight to the full moon? So posting that, and we'll work on this one until 8:24, and then we'll see how everyone's doing. doing with that question? Are we ready to move on to the next one? Yes. Yes, yes. Okay. For our next question. So I know the questions tonight are like pretty vague, but I kind of wanted them to be open so that you guys could really just do some deep exploring. And so this one, it's going to be, what in your life is in need of healing? Which, you know, it's kind of deep. So again, what in your life is in need of healing? And we'll work on this until 8:31, and I'll check in with you guys then.
Thank you.
Okay, so how's everyone doing? I feel like we're all good. Yeah, okay. So our last question for tonight is going to be, what does your life slash day look like if it is mostly peaceful and harmonious? And then what can you do to make it more like this, right? So we just thought about our relationships. We just thought about what it is that needs to be healed. Act as if everything you surrendered is gone. What does life look and feel like when, well, feeling it's peaceful and harmonious, yes, but what does it look like if it is the most peaceful and harmonious? And what can you do to make it more like that? I hope that makes sense. Okay, so we'll work on this question until 8:38, and then we'll move to some meditating and Reiki. I think everyone's good, right? Let me know if you want an extra minute or so. We can take it. Okay, cool. People are good. Okay. I was going to say, I'm going to take the silence as you're good. So we're going to move into meditating and using Reiki. And when I say using Reiki, I'm going to send you guys Reiki. And so I know a few people here haven't done Reiki with me before. So I just want to explain to you what happens. Reiki is a Japanese healing technique in which energy is sent basically via the hands. It's capable of going beyond distance and time. It is also capable of healing the past, the present, the future. In a sense, it's not changing us, but it's helping with the current emotions that we're having now. And for the future, it's like call waiting. So with Reiki, some things that may end up happening is that your fingers or your toes may start tingling. They may get hot or cold. You might feel waves come over your body. You might see objects or shapes. You might see colors. You may have emotions that just come up to the surface because the Reiki will be healing you on an emotional level as well. It does rebalance your chakras and your aura. So those are some of the things. You might also like gulp hard or your stomach may gurgle. Just know that all of this is healing. If emotions do come up, it's there to help you heal. So my best advice is to relax as much as you can. Welcome in this healing. It'll be very loving and very gentle. And if you don't feel anything at all, don't worry. It's still working. It doesn't matter. If you fall asleep, even better. So that might happen while I'm sending the Reiki. At the end of this, I am going to ask you to drink water to help because the Reiki does help release toxins and flush you out, but I will remind you. So for right now, you guys can stay seated or you can lay down. And I just want you to close your eyes, put your hands over your heart. It doesn't matter if it's the right or the left, that's on top or bottom. I want you to take a deep breath. And I want you to take another deep breath and I want you to notice your heartbeat. Just feel it. And I want you to allow yourself to start to relax and just feel how supported you are. Your heart is beating without you even thinking about it. How cool, right? So with tonight, with this meditation, you guys can just focus on this loving, healing light coming in and surrounding you as you surrender and you just welcome in healing, peace, and harmony. And so I want you to just bring your hands back to your heart if they're not there right now. And let's thank the full moon for this healing energy. Thank you, full moon, for taking all that no longer serves me. Thank you for this peace and calmness you have filled me with tonight. Thank you for surrounding me in so much love. I am open to continuing my journey in a magical, easy, exciting, joyful way. I am whole. I am cleansed. I am healed. I am light. I am free. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. And when you're ready, you're welcome to open your eyes, come back to the room. And if you're catching this on the replay on YouTube, feel free to subscribe to see all the other moon rituals we do throughout the month.